Hi, I'm Steve Andrews from SkybreedDisc.com and OldTrueWorldDiscGolf.com, and I'm going to do a series of videos that I'm going to call the Short Game Seminar. So it's about focusing on the short game, about really kind of getting up and down or getting in the basket from 200 feet and in. I know everyone wants more distance, and there's lots of things about getting more distance, but for lots of us, not just me who's in my mid-50s, but for lots of us, we're not gonna get to that top level distance. And the reality is that even if you did get to that top level distance, if you added 50 feet or 30 feet to your shot, it might not change your scores that much. Now on the other hand, if you can take getting from 30 feet to the basket and turn that into 10 feet of the basket, or find your way to scramble from all kinds of different locations, your score can go down immediately. So that's what we're gonna try and do. So in this first video, I just wanna talk about the kinds of tools that we're gonna need. Now, I like to have a lot of different discs for my short game. Now, not all of these, but I like to have a lot of different discs for my short game. Some people have fewer discs. And if you have some that are cycled that you can work, and we'll talk about that a little bit, you can use those. So this is four basic discs or four basic shots you need to have for your short game. The first one is a putter. I use a Maiden. I would advise a fairly stable, not overstable putter. Something like a Maiden or a Warden or a Judge or an AVR, you know, anything like that, you know, a Challenger, these kinds of things. Just a regular putting putter that you can depend on. The next shot you need is a understable putter. I like an understable putter to use for this shot, but what you need is a disc that when you throw it flat, it'll turn for a right-handed backhand, turn a little bit to the right. It'll go to the right. So if you throw it flat, it'll go to the right. And the other thing is that if you need to throw an Anheuser, a soft Anheuser, you can throw a soft Anheuser and it'll hold to the right all the way without fighting at it. Now, if you can do that shot with a beat-in version of your putter, a beat-in Maiden, a beat-in Warden, then that's great. I like to use a Deputy for that shot, or you know, a Deputy or a Swan or a Fierce, something like that. Then you need a straight flying putter that has a little bit of stability at the end of its flight. And this is going to be for straight shots, and you need to have a throwing putter that you trust. Again, if you putt with a Judge and a Judge, you have a Judge that flies really great for you, you can use a Judge. But a Jawbreaker, a Luna, a Judge, an AVR, any of these kinds of things. So you want an understable putter, your putting putter, and then a fairly stable putter that will fly straight when thrown flat and then fall off a little bit to the left. And the final thing that you really need is an overstable putter. Now, there's a lot of different ones. You can use a Pig. You can use, I use a Harp. Harp is great. You can use a Harp. Or you can use a Zone. These are all great ones. You can use any three. There's other kinds of putters that you can use. You want something that you can trust on forehands and something you can trust on Anheuser backhand shots, right? So you want to have these, and again, you might be able to cycle these discs through and use multiple kinds of the same of a disc in different forms of wear, but an understable putter that'll fly straight and turn over to the right, throwing flat, and hold an Anheuser, an overstable disc that you can use for forehands and Anheusers, and a straight flying putter. Now, there's one more that I like to use that not everybody wants to use, and this is kind of a tweener disc. For me, it's a Suspect. You can also, a Jawbreaker Zone is perfect for this. This is going to be a disc that's going to fall between your throwing putter, like a Judge, and your overstable putter, like a Harp, or a kind of a Flex Zone, or a Z Zone. For this shot, I like to use this. Not everyone wants to carry one. I like this because I can throw the exact same shot I would throw with a Harp, but it goes about 20 or 30, 40 feet longer using the same kind of effort. I don't have to change my mechanics. Whereas if I'm going to throw a forehand with a Harp, I might have to flex it a little bit to get the distance I want. I can throw that same shot with a flat with a Suspect, and it'll work out great. Jawbreaker Zone is a great, if you use a Zone as your overstable Anheuser flex shot or forehand shot, then a Jawbreaker Zone is a perfect version of that. More stable probably than your throwing putter, but not as stable as the kind of overstable kind of workhorse you use. The other place you want to really want to use these, and we'll talk about these in a later video, is that a disc like a Suspect or a Jawbreaker Zone is perfect for putting in the wind. When I played the DDO or the Glass Blown Open, 25 mile an hour winds, you need to have a putter that you can just throw like a regular putter. You could putt with a harp, you could putt with a zone in that, but you're really gonna have to hammer that putt and change your mechanics. Whereas if you have something that's more stable than your regular putter, but not really overstable, something like a suspect or a jawbreaker zone, I could putt with my regular mechanics on that and make putts without having to change anything, even into really good winds. Okay, so these are our basic tools, and we're gonna use these, and we'll talk about it in the next couple of videos upcoming. Thanks so much, I hope you'll join me, and I hope it'll help you get lower scores.